Hello friends, welcome back. Today we will solve the second problem of week 1, which is min-max sum. Let's understand the problem. Here we have given 5 integers in an array, and we have to calculate minimum and maximum sum of exactly 4 of 5 integers. And remember, we have to print the maximum and minimum sum in this order. First, minimum sum, then space, then maximum sum. By reading, you will easily understand this question. So, now time is to think about how we will find this solution. Solution is simple. If we subtract max number from sum of array elements, then the answer will be minimum sum of 4 of 5 elements. And like that, if we subtract min number from sum of array elements, we will get maximum sum of 4 of 5 elements. To calculate max and min number, we will use integer.max value and integer.min value. These are constants of the integer class. If we hover on it, we can see what values are stored inside these variables. Let's convert this logic in the program. To get max num and min num, we have to compare the maximum and minimum value of integer data type. So first, we will store max value in min num variable and minimum value in max num variable. But why we are storing it in opposite way? Because first we will compare these values with all array elements, and then we will get max and min number from array. So in for loop, we will see if array element is greater than max num, then that element will be stored in the max num variable. Same for the min num. In same for loop, we will calculate the sum of all elements. So it's time to print. So to print min num, we will subtract the max num from sum, and then to print max num, we will subtract min num from sum. But here we can see red color, it's a warning. For this, we will cover these both operations in bracket, and red color will gone. Let's run this. Test case is passed. But after submission, some test cases are not passing here. What can be reason? Actually, here some test cases are big in size. And here in constraints also, we can see integer size can be 1 to 10 raised to 9. And integer data type limit is also same. But when we are doing addition of all elements, that time sum, which is the type of integer, can't hold the result. For that, we need the data type which can store bigger values than integer limit. So we will replace long in the place of integer only for sum. Now all test cases are passing. I think you understood each line of the program. If you have any doubt or suggestion, then comment below. Thanks for watching.